A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 5th March, on the front page you have COVID-19 cases rise to 29 in India. So now 15 Italian tourists, including the wife of an already infected person, and 8 Indians have tested positive for coronavirus COVID-19, taking the total number of cases in the country to 29. Two cases with high viral load were also detected in Telangana. Is there a Paytm employee has tested positive in Gurugram? And here you have Supreme Court asks High Court to list Delhi riot cases on March 6. So Supreme Court has said it was unjustified on the part of Delhi High Court to delay hearing the pleas for arrest and prosecution of leaders who instigated the communal rampage in the national capital, and directed High Court to list the petitions for 6th March Friday. So earlier, the High Court had adjourned the cases to 13th April. So this unjustified delay has been pointed out. Supreme Court was also petitioned by the petitioner's advocate, and Supreme Court at that time, we should recollect, had said that it is not that we are responsible. So now Supreme Court has asked the Delhi High Court to take up the hearings and take up the hearings on March 6 itself. That is tomorrow. Then, this is regarding again Nirbhaya case. It keeps coming in news that the mercy petition has been rejected. So again, a new date will have to be finalized, because according to Delhi prison rules, 14-day period has to be given to a death row convict after the dismissal of a clemency plea, that is mercy petition. And this is, violence was one-sided, says Delhi Minorities Panel. So, Delhi Minorities Commission, in an assessment report of the Delhi riots, has concluded that the violence was one-sided, well-planned, and with support from local people, and most damage was done to shops and houses belonging to the minority community. Then below you have Supreme Court frees trade in cryptocurrencies, annuls RBI curb. So, Supreme Court has set aside an April 6, 2018 circular of RBI that prohibited banks and entities regulated by it from providing services in relation to virtual currencies. So, Supreme Court bench observed that RBI has not come out with a stand that any of these entities regulated by it, like nationalized banks, scheduled commercial banks, NBFCs, etc., have suffered any loss or adverse effect directly or indirectly due to virtual currency exchanges. So there is no such loss as such, then why why banks are being prohibited from providing any services in relation to virtual currency. So that's why the Supreme Court has now annulled RBI order that was its circular on April 6, 2018. So it calls the RBI circular disproportionate with an otherwise consistent stand taken by RBI that virtual currencies were not prohibited in the country. So RBI consistently maintained that virtual currencies are not illegal, but then virtual currencies were cautioned against, and then it came up with this circular to prohibiting banks from having any connection with them. On page 8 you have, we want to be worthy of the uniform we wear. So this is what the first batch of women recruits to the army say. They have been recruited now as the first women soldiers and will be inducted in the army in April 2021 after undergoing rigorous 61-week training program. So there are 100 recruits aged between 17 and 21 who will be part of corps of military police, and many have convinced their family to allow them into this traditional male bastion now. So some are also following the footsteps of their fathers. On page 9 you have COVID-19, government for universal screening. So government has now planned to have universal screening at all international airports in the country. So these steps would be introduced to combat the deadly coronavirus, COVID-19. So this is the decision which has been taken recently at a crucial meeting chaired by Principal Secretary to the Prime Minister. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Rights or Wrong. So this is regarding UN body's Citizenship Amendment Act move. We saw yesterday on the front page, UN High Commissioner for Human Rights has become a petitioner, as one of the petitioners in the Citizenship Amendment Act case. And this act as such, the editorial says, may be unwarranted, may be not be required, but government must abide by its equal protection duty. that in our country, everyone, irrespective of being a citizen or not, is given equal protection of law, equality before law and equal protection of law under Article 14 of the Constitution. Then next is advantage BB. So this is regarding Israel. So Benjamin Netanyahu has won another term as Israeli Prime Minister, and this is not good for West Asia and Palestine, is what the editorial argues. So there has been parliamentary elections, three parliamentary elections in 12 months. So now Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has emerged as a clear winner and can form the government. Earlier there was lack of clarity, lack of sufficient majority, because of which re-elections had to be held. Nobody got clear majority. This is there. So he had been assertive and has announced his plans to even take over Israeli region of West Bank. US under President Trump has been supporting Israel. And the lead article is the sum and substance of the Afghan deal. So this is regarding the US Taliban deal. So US Taliban deal has been finalized, but now an intra-Afghan deal is expected. But then Taliban continues to target Afghan security forces, the Afghan police and the Afghan army, which will not allow peace to prevail. So this article says that US is on its way out and this does not ensure peace for the people of Afghanistan. Then below you have Dark Tales in Andhra Pradesh IIT Success Story. So this article talks about a study on secondary education in the state. So this study shows coaching starts too early amid immense pressure on students. So though Andhra Pradesh has been a success with IIT coaching, but it is in with immense pressure being put on children from an early start at a very young age. Then on your pet page you have what Kejriwal should have done. So this is in the context of Delhi riots, and it says Delhi Chief Minister's lack of response and status quo stance led to further spread of violence. And this is caught in a bureaucratic web. So this talks about Assam residents. The process of NRC has become a punishment. They are proving citizenship before courts and tribunals now. So that is the process involved. And this is Trump 2.0. We see more slash and burn unilateralism. So if President Donald Trump wins another term as US President, which the presidential elections are due at the end of this year, so then it says India should be prepared for more arbitrary duties, because again he'll go for unilateral approaches towards tariffs and other provisions too. That is a caution being raised here. On page 12 you have Amit Din, Lok Sabha approves tax resolution bill. So direct tax Vivad Se Vishwas bill that seeks to expedite resolution of pending tax disputes has been passed by Lok Sabha, even as proceedings in both houses of parliament were paralyzed for the third day in a row because of opposition's demand for an immediate discussion on Delhi riots. And below you have social media makes silent comeback to valley. So nearly 65 lakh mobile internet users in Kashmir were able to use social media platforms after 7 months. The order was issued by the government on internet connectivity, but it is silent on whether the ban imposed on social media on Jan 25 has been withdrawn or not. But access has been provided now. And this is IBC bill discriminates against home buyers. So this is Insolvency and Bankruptcy Court, Second Amendment Bill of 2019. So it is said this bill, opposition claims, is discriminatory as it does not treat home buyers on par with other financial creditors and violates a Supreme Court ruling. So this is there. The bill has been introduced and it has a new clause that sets a threshold of 100 home buyers or 10% of the buyers in a residential project, whichever is less, as a requirement to jointly take the developer to insolvency court. Means individual home buyer who is a financial creditor cannot file insolvency application. So these creditors, there are said to be operational creditors, you know, who actually help in operation of the company, and others are creditors who actually provide credits. So like banks, which provide credit to the companies. So Mumbaiers are not like banks who have provided credit to the company, but still they have a stake, and Supreme Court has also ruled on treating them well in any insolvency case. So the provisions in the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Amendment Bill of these 100 home buyers or 10% coming together and taking the developer to insolvency court has been objected to by the opposition. On international page here, you have this coverage on US presidential elections, the primaries which are taking place. So you can see. Then you have US launches strikes on Taliban, calls for halt of needless attacks. So now the militant group has mounted attacks on Afghan forces, and US has carried out its first airstrike on Taliban fighters since signing of the troop withdrawal agreement. Then on business page you have not for changes to Companies Act for decriminalizing offenses. So Center has proposed to amend the Companies Act again in a bid to decriminalize a number of offenses and ease corporate social responsibility requirements, especially for smaller companies. So this amendment bill will enable the listing of Indian companies on stock exchanges in foreign jurisdictions, and this will give Indian firms greater access to capital, a broader investor base, and also better valuations. Also, with respect to CSR, the amendment will ensure that companies which have obligation to spend 50 lakh per annum or less on corporate social responsibility are no longer required to have a CSR committee. So companies that spend more than the mandatory 2% on CSR in a particular year can carry it forward as credit for fulfillment of CSR obligations for the next few years too. So this has been announced by the government. So this is where you can see bond yields decline on expectations of rate cuts. So this is with respect to US Central Bank, US Federal Reserve. So US Federal Reserve reduced the interest rates to fight the economic slowdown due to spread of coronavirus too. So there is growing expectation in the domestic market that RBI will also follow suit. And because of this rate cut, bond yields, government bond yields have also declined. Then this is regarding Supreme Court order on cryptocurrency. It says this order will only offer temporary relief because government's draft law, which is there, proposes to ban private currencies. So RBI had prohibited them. Now government is also proposing to ban them under a law. And this is cabinet allows NRIs to take 100% in Air India. So Union Cabinet has decided to allow non-resident Indians who are Indian nationals to own up to 100% stake in Air India, which is bound for disinvestment. And this is public sector bank mergers get approval. So you can see the consolidation of 10 public sector banks into 4 will take place, which is detailed out here how it would be brought into effect. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asia.com. Thank you.